When you arrive at the mayor's house, there is a young visitor already there. She looks to be making an impassioned request of Greith. In a wearied voice, Greith replies, "There is no longer any maiden in our village." Admonished, the girl leaves the house with disappointment written across her expression. You inform the mayor that you've taken care of the monsters around town. As thanks for completing the job, the mayor hands you a basket of fruit. Oh, good, you think to yourself. Another day, another basket of fruit. You re-enter the grotto and announce your return. On a normal day, Laddie would already have zipped over to greet you. But today, nothing. You walk over to Laddie and discover that she is sound asleep. Life in the grotto is not one of creature comforts. Rather, a fair few inconveniences. You've tried several times to bring Laddie to the village, but she was adamantly opposed on every occasion. You sometimes catch glimpses of her face while she sleeps. Always it is contorted in anguish, as though she is in the throes of a terrible nightmare. You notice a bulky book lying open next to Laddie, filled with carefully drawn words and images. It seems to be some kind of picture book that Laddie made herself. You know, I confess, I am a bit... Unable to overcome your curiosity, you decide to take a look at the picture book. Beside evocative images of deep forests and towering mountain ranges, Laddie has written a story patterned after the maiden's myth. The picture book story is set in a small village replete with nature. The village enjoys the promise of peace and tranquility, thanks to the young woman born to be the maiden. The maiden goes before the altar to perform a ritual, which invokes the power of a great spirit to protect the village. You look over the artwork, a spitting recreation of the altar you saw in the spire, and think back on the mysterious voice. The voice claimed it was a spirit, and you're certain it spoke Laddie's name. You are so caught up in the thoughts racing through your head that you fail to notice Laddie had awakened. Lattie seems embarrassed that you've seen her book. Tears prick the corners of her eyes. If Lattie were indeed the maiden, it would be no exaggeration to call her the very light of hope, a protective force that could save the island from its encroaching ruin. With faint expectation tightening your chest, you consider taking her to the altar in the spire. You've given Lattie some of the fruit you brought back. She dreamily stuffs some of it into her mouth. Maybe she likes it. You hope so. Your stomach rumbles as you watch her. And together, the two of you enjoy a light meal. You take Lattie with you and return to the spire. As you approach the entrance of the spire, the staff that Lattie clutches close begins to emit a faint light. Seeing the mysterious light, you are convinced. Lattie has a deep connection to the spire, her expression uneasy. Lattie takes hold of your sleeve with a tentative touch. You stand before the altar once more, bathed in an air of mysticism. The light emitting from Lattie's staff intensifies, as if indicating its destination. In response to the enigmatic voice, Lattie's staff exudes a dazzling light. A spirit appears right before your eyes. Well, maybe it's a spirit? It's some kind of strange stuffed animal. The stuffed toy seems to be affecting a voice of considerable gravitas and choking itself in the process. This creature is called Black. Though you cannot be certain it speaks the truth, it claims to be a spirit. You approach, hoping to ask about the maiden. But with blinding speed, Lack zooms behind Lattie, putting her between you as a shield. "You're the one from before," Lack says, quaking. It would appear that you're mistaking the creature for a monster, and doggedly chasing after it has made it rather afraid of you. You hold out an offer of reconciliation, and Lack takes it and immediately starts munching away. You're not really sure if the make-good worked out, but in any event, Lack looks willing to listen to you now. You ask about the maiden once more, and Lack begins to talk a lot. It seems to enjoy doing so. Just as the maiden's myth handed down amongst the denizens of the island suggests, it explains, Lattie was indeed born to be the maiden here. However, she was unable to take up her role. This has caused no small amount of distress over the island's inevitable destiny to sink beneath the raging waves. Lack concludes with a proposal. How's about you go and meet with the other maidens and fetch the maiden's relics? As you had hoped, Laddie appears to be the key to the island's salvation. This island is not the only one home to a spirit. There are islands throughout this archipelago, and upon each dwells one of the four maidens who govern their own spirit. The self-proclaimed spirit explains that if you bring the maiden's relics that each of these maidens possess back to this spire, Laddie will be able to become a maiden herself. Laddie shows the staff in her hand, wearing an expression that seems to say, "This is a maiden's relic." You ask, "Should we kill the maidens and steal the relics?" Laddie shakes her head rapidly, as if to insist that you definitely should not do that. As Lack explains, each maiden has an attendant, an escort, and protector. This would make it difficult to take the relics by brute force. If Laddie becomes a maiden and performs the maiden's ritual at the altar, the island can be saved. The world-changing immensity of what you have just learned echoes in your mind. It takes you a little while to fully digest it. But it does just so happen you've been readying a seaworthy vessel for your own purposes. You accept Lack's proposal to help Laddie become a maiden. So, you want me to poof you back to the entrance? You decide to make for the spire's exit.